Hello children, how are you? I hope that everybody are fine, staying safe at home. Okay, this is your Saubhagya madam, and without any late, let us start our next video. Before we start our video, let us have a review of the last video. What we have learned in the last video, we have seen the different reactions of different liquids or the acids or bases that we generally use in our daily life, were the methyl orange and phenolphthalein, right children? I hope that you have done few experiments at home, which was given as your homework. Have you prepared the papers with the given homework? If you have done, please try to post your results in your 7th class WhatsApp group, children, so that the other children who have not done also will get inspired by the work which you have done. Okay, and we will also feel very happy that our children are learning something sitting at your home. Okay, children. So now we were discussing about the different reactions which are generally seen by the chemicals or the acids or the bases. And now today we are going to learn one more example or one more chemical reaction that is going place. Okay, for this chemical reaction to be done, the procedure name is, or the experiment name is, the reaction of the metals with the naturally absorbing acids. For example, we will take citric acid. Citric acid means it is mostly found in the lemon and oranges, children, as we already know that. So this is a natural acid which we get from the fruits. So by using this citric acid, we are going to test how the citric acid is reacting with different metals. So without that, we'll see the experiment now. See children, what are the ingredients or the materials required to do this experiment? Lemon juice, a small piece of copper, zinc, magnesium, iron, brass and aluminium metals. So here we are taking six metals. Those are copper, zinc, magnesium, iron, brass and aluminium. We have to take small pieces of these metals for this experiment, and also lime juice. Okay, now the things required to conduct any experiment, we need few things in advance so that we will make this experiment with exact and accurate results. Okay, what are the things required? We have to require, see here, six beakers. To take all this, we have to take six beakers and the pipettes and matchsticks. Sorry, children. Beakers, pipettes and matchsticks. So, here in this experiment, what we are going to do? We are taking six glass beakers. And onto these six glass beakers, we are going to put six metals. So what are the metals? The copper, zinc, magnesium, iron, brass and aluminium. We take few pieces of metals and we will drop into the six beakers. Okay, now we will take a pipette. With the help of pipette, we will collect lemon juice. Okay, we will collect some lemon juice in a beaker, and with that help of a pipette, we will drop the lemon juice into the beakers individually. Okay, now we will wait for a few seconds. When you wait for a few seconds, you can clearly see the metal will react with the acid. Here, the acid is nothing but the lemon juice. The lemon juice contains citric acid. Yes, the citric acid is now reacting with the metal pieces which are present in the glass beakers. Okay, when you do that, after a few minutes, you have to take a matchstick and try to put into the beaker like this. Dip the matchstick and put it into the beaker. When you put the matchstick into the beaker, you can observe a popping sound. You can observe a popping sound, and also the matchstick will light very brightly. The flames go very bright. What is the reason behind this? The reason behind this experiment is nothing but when a metal reacts with the acid, when a metal reacts with an acid, a gas is is produced. That gas is nothing but hydrogen gas. So once when we do this experiment, there is an observation we can see. When the given six metals react with the lime juice, they produce hydrogen gas. What they are producing? Hydrogen gas. When you bring a lighted matchstick into the beakers, we can hear a popping sound and the matchstick glows brightly. So this is the observation which we have seen. So when a metal reacts with an acid, hydrogen gas is produced. This hydrogen gas is a colorless gas. It doesn't have any color. Okay, children. So whenever a matchstick or a light is brought near to the hydrogen gas, it will provide you with popping sound. You can hear a clear popping sound. Okay, and also the light will brighten up more. You'll see the reaction. See, here we are taking zinc metal and hydrochloric acid. The zinc metal, when it reacts with an hydrochloric acid, what is formed here? What is formed? The zinc will combine with the chloride. See, zinc chloride will formed. Zinc chloride will form, and the byproduct is hydrogen gas. So this arrow indicates that it is a gas. Okay, a metal reacting with an acid will give you a compound, new compound, and hydrogen gas. This hydrogen gas is been identified by an Italian scientist called Henry Cavendish. This person have conducted experiments on different chemicals, how they are reacting with the metals, and he have identified a gas which is colorless, that is called as hydrogen gas. You know, children, have you ever heard the hydrogen bombs? Yes, the hydrogen bombs are also produced or prepared by using this hydrogen gas. So it is very dangerous gas when it is taken in larger amount. Okay, the hydrogen gas is colorless gas, and it when the fire comes near to it, it gives a big popping sound and it will burst. Okay, that is the technique behind the hydrogen bombs. Okay, children, I'll ask you one question. In your home, if you have any brass metal, you call that bindalu, in which you store water, have you ever seen? Okay, when you observe that, if you leave the water in the brass container for a few days, after that, if you remove the water, you can observe a greenish brown color which is present inside the metal. Why it is happening? Why? Because the metal is reacting with the hydrogen present in the water. H2O is a molecular formula of water, H2O. So here the reaction is taking place between the water and the metal container, and here a precipitation is formed. It is in greenish color. చూడండి, రాగి పాత్రలు ఇత్తడి పాత్రలు అని అంటారు. ఇత్తడి పాత్రలో కానీ రాగి పాత్రలో కానీ నీళ్లు వదిలేస్తే మీకు ఎలా కనిపిస్తుంది అంటే, కొన్ని రోజులకి పచ్చగా ఫామ్ అయిపోతుందంట. అది ఒకలాంటి గ్రీనిష్ కలర్తో ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. సో ఇఫ్ యూ క్లీన్ ఇట్ విత్ లెమన్, సో అగైన్ ఇట్ విల్ రియాక్ట్ అండ్ ద మెటల్ విల్ బికమ్ వెరీ బ్రైట్. హ్యావ్ యూ ఎవర్ అబ్జర్వ్? మీ ఇంట్లో మీ మదర్ వాళ్ళు కడుగుతూ ఉంటారు చూడండి, ఇత్తడి పాత్రలు రాగి పాత్రలు కడుగుతూ ఉంటారు. క్వైట్ ఆఫెన్ ద క్లీన్ ఇట్ అప్ so that the color change will again become bright. Okay, children, so there is nothing but the chemical reaction which is taking place there. Okay, and one more thing is, if you observe, in the olden days only porcelain jars are being used. Porcelain and glass jars are used to store the pickles. Even now also we follow it. Either we store the pickles in a porcelain jar or in a plastic jar or in a glass jar. Why not in a metal jar? Why we are not storing in them? Why? Because if you take a pickle, it contains salt and it also contains some acid in it. Okay, if you store them in the metallic jars, what will happen? The acids and salts will react with the metal container and the pickles have been spoiled. So you cannot use them. So if you leave it like that, what will happen? The greenish layer will be formed over over the pickle, so which is spoiling the pickle itself. So we cannot eat those pickles. That is the only reason behind. Why? Because here the metallic, the reaction, the chemical reaction is taking place in between the metal and the acids or bases or salts which are present in the pickle. So we cannot store them in the metal jars. So this is also one of the reason why we are not using the metallic jars to store the pickles. Okay children, now we will see another important topic, acid rains. Okay, acid rains. Here the name itself is showing you there is some acid in the rain. We know that rainwater is the purest form of water. Have you learned in your lower classes, children? Yes. But why the water of the rain is been converted to acid? Why the acids are spoiling us? Do you know, acids are very harsh chemicals which will spoil the things. If the acid is fallen on our skin, it eats away our skin. So it is a very dangerous chemical. So acids, whenever we are working with acids, we have to take special precautions and also be very cautious with them. Now we will see what is the acid rain. Acid rain. How this acid rain is formed? The acid rain is formed because of the presence of carbonic acid, sulfuric acid and nitric acid in the atmosphere. So we know that the atmosphere contains air around us. The atmosphere contains air around us. You know, there are different gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide and argon. Okay, we also know the percentage of gases which are present in the atmosphere, which we have learned in our class 5. But from where do we are getting these acids? This carbonic acid, the sulfuric acid and the nitric acid. These are not present in the atmosphere, but from where do we are getting? Do you know, children, the factories, the different kinds of factories are releasing out smoke into the atmosphere. These industries or the factories releases unwanted smoke into the atmosphere. This unwanted smoke which is released into the atmosphere contains sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide and carbon dioxide. What does these waste gases contain? Sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide and carbon dioxide. These are the byproducts of some chemical reactions in the industries. When these oxides react with the moisture in the atmosphere, we know the atmosphere is humid. Humid means it contains some amount of moisture. Tema and antar telugulo. Tema kaligi untundi. Atmosphere lo ela untundi? Tema kaligi untundi. When these acids are reacted with the moisture, they form into the acids. The hydroxides or the oxides, which when reacted with the atmospheric moisture, they convert into the acids. When these acids mix with the rainwater, they fall onto the earth back as acid rains. Acid rains causes major damage to the people or the things in the world. How they are causing? See, if we are reacting with the acid rain, the skin of the human beings or the animals will get some boils. The skin will burn away because of the acid which is present in the rain. And also the monuments and buildings. The monuments and the buildings are also being spoiled. And also the crops. Even the plants cannot take these acids. Why? Because they are very dangerous. Their plants will die away. And the monuments like the Taj Mahal, which is very famous monument in India, is been suffering with this acid rain. Because of the acid rain, the Taj Mahal, which is made up of marble, it is made up of white marble. The marble is reacting with these acids which are falling from the rain, and the marble is been eroded. అరిగిపోతుంది. అరిగిపోయి కరిగిపోయి అదంతా వెళ్ళిపోతుంది. దానివల్ల ఏమైపోతుంది అంటే ఆ తాజ్ మహల్ యొక్క అందం అంతా పోతుంది. ఓకే, బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద యాసిడ్ రెయిన్స్ ద So monuments like Red Fort, Taj Mahal, all these are being damaged. Why? Because even the Red Fort also is made up of limestone. The limestone also contains lime in it. So this also react with the acids. See children, it is our duty to make sure to protect our environment. Always protecting our environment will protect ourselves. It is nothing but vice versa. If we protect the environment protects us. If we are producing more amount of carbon dioxide or the waste gases into the atmosphere cannot take it, and in result, it gives us back in the form of acid rain. Do you know, children? Even the motor cars, the buses, the cars, the vehicles, and the scooters and the bikes also release these dangerous gases. These gases are causing not only pollution, the pollution which is in result causing us many skin damages, lung damages. All these are being seen in the human beings and in the animals. And the acid rains are damaging the monuments, the people, and also the crops, which are very useful for us. So we have to take care that the pollution rate is reduced day by day. But due to the human unwanted reactions or the human recklessness, the environment is being spoiled. So as we human beings have to take care about the environment, we have to protect it, plant more trees, reduce the usage of unwanted things which is causing some damage to our mother nature. Okay, so this is the importance of the acid rains. So the acid rains which are present or which are formed due to the carbonic acid, sulfuric acid and the nitric acid, which is more in the atmosphere in the higher amounts, which are released from the factories and also from the automobiles. So these are causing the acid rain. Okay, children. We know, children, acid rains are also being witnessed by our Andhra Pradesh. You know that, children? If you have seen the Fort region or near the Chowal Madu, the factories there are being regularly eroded because of the acid rains. Why? Because Visakhapatnam is an industrialized corridor where the more amount of industries are present. From the Chowal Madu junction towards the BHPV, all the area is completely presented with the many different types of industries. Here the pollution rate is also very high, and also the more usage of automobiles is also been increasing day by day. So the effect of the acid rain is even seen in our Visakhapatnam area. So be cautious, children. As we are the citizens of Visakhapatnam, we need to have some love towards our city, and we have to protect our city from this acid rain. Okay, children. Okay, we have seen how the acid rains are coming, and we will see more other things or the chemical reactions in our further videos, children. That's all for this video, and let us have a clear understanding of what all the chemical reactions that we have learned in this video. Take care, children. Thank you.